Kind of chilly this morning. Nice hit here. He's still on there, baby. Come on. Did he come off? He came off. That was a nice hit. Where did he hit? Can't tell. That was the short rod. Put him right back.
What's going on, fishing buddies? Welcome back to the channel. I can't believe I'm about to say this, but it's cold. It's like 61 degrees. We got a stiff north wind. Did not bring a sweatshirt, and I'm regretting it. Today, guys, we're gonna do some fishing, and I'm gonna go over what I have in my beach cart every trip out. Let's get it out there.
What we got here? Blue runner.
Here we go.
Oh, come on. Come on. Oh. Little pump. Been catching these little pumps lately. All of them up close. Oh, he's still on there. He's still on there. Oh, remora. So many of these lately. Just picked up a whiting on my deep rod. Camera didn't turn on. K-Pomp's rig, big chunk of whiting on that slider fish finder. There we go, what we got here? A little something. A little blue runner. I might use him for bait.
All right, guys, with the beach cart, I am gonna start with my bag. I bring one bag. I've gone through probably three different ones, and I've settled on this duffel style bag. I have a love-hate relationship with it because there's only, you know, one pocket. There's not a bunch of different little pockets that I can kind of organize. But I have found that with the duffel style bag, for me personally, it helps with the camera equipment if it starts raining. With these microphones and everything, you don't want to get those wet, and it's real easy to kind of throw all my camera equipment in here. There's plenty of room. So this is what I've settled on probably for the last 6 months. It's been effective for me. Again, everything just gets thrown down into the one pocket, so you kind of got to dig around to find stuff, which is a little frustrating at times. But for waterproofing and the sand, this material just keeps all the sand off of it, so I'm not dragging sand back and forth to my house, which is excellent. So this is what I've been using, and this is effective for me. Let me show you what's inside. Stuff coming out is just a variety of fish bites. I always bring a variety, and what I'll do with them once I get to the beach is this little pocket I keep here, usually where my sand flea rake is. I throw them there, so now I just have them ready to grab. Again, just a bunch of different varieties of fish bites for my synthetic baits. Next up, a couple tackle boxes. Sometimes I bring three tackle boxes, one with some heavier lures and some topwater poppers. I didn't bring that today. These are just my little twitch baits, things like that. I was hoping to see something blowing up early this morning. I did not, but I always have a few tackle boxes. Just got one today. And then my rig box. This is just a flat box with no dividers. This is excellent to keep my rigs in. As you can see, just a bunch of different colors. Frisky fins and K-Pomps Pompano rigs. He makes some big boy rigs. So that's what I'm using with him. These are an example. I have picked up a rig bag, I guess is what it's called, from Florida Surf Tackle. And it has dividers in it and things like that. I probably am going to transition over to that. I just haven't made the move yet. Next up, what do we got? I got my little weight box. This little box is perfect for these little pyramid weights. I picked this up a couple years ago and I've never felt the need to use anything else. Got all my pyramids in there. And this is what I use for my K-Pomps big boy rigs. Couple different sizes of leader, 40 pound and 20 pound. The 40 pound I'll tie on when I'm casting these poppers, spoons, just to kind of combat the bluefish, Spanish, things with teeth. Always keep a little bit of leader. My longer pliers for stingrays and sharks, basically. Try to keep my fingers away from those sharks' mouth, so those help. I use these probably at least once every time I come out here. The stingrays too. I don't like to get too close to those stingrays, so I'll use these just to kind of give me a little extra distance. And then these guys, for usually the only time I'm using these is for the bigger drum, kind of get those bigger drum up on the beach, get them spread out for pitchers. These are great for pitchers, guys. You can get that guy a good spread with these. You got a good grip on him. So I'm always bringing these two guys here. Of course, I got the sand flea rake, and here's a tip. This is just happened to fall in the video. I have that whiting cut up, and I have the other pieces of the whiting here. What I'll do is throw it in the sand flea rake and kind of stick it under my cart like that, and that will combat the birds from getting it. They can still get it, but they're gonna have to work at it, and I can, you know, I can see if they're over here. It gives me time to kind of get over here and chase them off. So that's something I've been doing. I put my cut bait in my rake there, kind of stick it under my cart, so I got that bar running across it, and that'll keep the birds away. Bait knife. Today I got some fresh dead shrimp, so I keep that down in the basket. Also throw my sand fleas in there. I got my scissors, and then I have my weights that I'm using for all Pompano setups. These are the Sinker Guy Spudniks, 4 ounce, 2 ounce, and a 3 ounce. I throw the 3 ounce probably 90% of the time. When I got real rough surf, I'll bump it up to the 4. The 2, I'll put those 2s on there every once in a while when I'm just kind of throwing right off the front of the beach here for whiting and things like that, when it's real flat. But the reasoning for me throwing the 3 ounce 90% of the time is just to kind of build the muscle memory with throwing the weight. I try to keep away from throwing a bunch of different weights, just random weights. I just stick to the 3 ounce. As you can see, it's pretty flat today. I'm still throwing 3 ounce. You can also get these rings from the Sinker Guy. Once he introduced these, I've been sold ever since. They just screw off really easily here. They're not gonna rust. And these are super cheap and super effective. I just run them through the holes of the cutting board there, and I've always got my weights. That was an issue when I first started using those Spudnik weights. Like, how do I keep these things? They were just kind of down in the bag or in the side of the beach cart here. And I really wasn't satisfied with that. Sinker guy came out with these, and I've been using them ever since. I keep a fairly small cooler. As you can see, the ruler on it goes up to 15 inches. I do have a bigger ruler on the beach cart to measure bigger fish. But really, from what I'm keeping out here, pompano, whiting, Spanish, bluefish, or even reds, but the slot red in Florida, I can still fit in here, and you can only keep one anyway. It all fits in here. And I also use this same cooler for kayak fishing. It just fits great. I like how if I put it in the middle, the bars of the beach cart support it, and I still have room on both sides here and here for my sand spikes. I always bring a smaller setup for casting lures. This is an 8-foot Cajun Helibomb. This is a great rod. I love this thing. 4000 series pin, Battle 3, high speed, 20-pound braid on that. Then I have two identical 12-foot frisky fin rods, Battle 3 pins, 20-pound braid. Again, two identical star rods, 10-foot. 4000 series pins, Battle 3, the DX series, 20-pound braid. Another tip is when you have these longer sand spikes, when I'm packing up, I always put the top end down in the cart, and I let the end that was in the sand come out the front. That way, the sand is not bouncing around up here, possibly getting on my reels. Always keep some magic thread just to tie on fresh dead shrimp, ghost shrimp. When I'm giving it a good heave, when I'm launching it far out there, they tend to fly off. So that helps. You can pick this up at the sinker guy also. That's where I get this from. And that's it, guys. That's how I'm running every trip. A lot of trial and error figuring this out. You know, I would suggest the same. Try some things out. If it's not working, switch it up. Lock yourself down a routine, and you're not gonna forget things in the garage. Like, I was constantly forgetting things in the garage because I didn't have really a set plan of what I was taking. I was just kind of grabbing stuff. All right, I know I need this. I might need this, so I'm gonna bring this. And it was just jumbled. There was no organization to it. And it took me time to kind of nail it down. And there's no cookie cutter way to do this thing, guys. You find what works for you and then stick with it. The only thing that I could think of that I don't have that I sometimes bring is a ghost shrimp pump. Guys, if you enjoyed the video, please hit me a like, hit me a subscribe. It really helps out the rhythm of the channel. You can check me out on Facebook. You can check me out on Instagram. Till next time, guys, it's cold. I'm going home.